Hello everyone, I'm Richard Quinn and this is Crystal, who works alongside me in my design team. So my job is as a designer and I design under my own name, and we show at London Fashion Week each season, as well as doing lots of celebrity dressing, event dressing, and we also do a lot of collaboration. So we'll talk you through from the beginning, I guess is probably the best place to start, where I started at my career path in taking GCSE art and design, and that was really fundamentally where I flourished, what I enjoyed doing most. And I was very academic as well. My parents were always quite insistent. I did quite academic subjects alongside it. So at A levels, I did art and design, graphics, but then I also did business and government politics. And then I applied. At the time, you could apply through directly to the university where I went, which was Central St Martin's, which, for those who don't know, is probably one of the most elite, if not the most elite, art and design school in the world. And it's part of the University of the Arts London. So Crystal went to London College of Fashion, which is a college within that group, that kind of cluster of universities. But I went to Central St Martin's and I did my foundation there. And within the foundation in art and design, you get to choose lots of different pathways because there's so many diverse and dynamic things that you can do with art and design, whether you want to go into interiors, graphic design, costume design, theatre design. But then I settled on what I was most passionate about, which was textile and print design. So I explored that through my foundation. Actually, sorry, just to go back a step, I applied for, so I got into different universities to study law. So I had the option to study law and apply to the art design universities directly. But anyway, I went for art and design because I didn't want to study law, for me, for obvious reasons. So then I went to Central St Martin's, tried lots of different things out, and then I flourished in print in terms of textiles and fabrics. That's kind of where my interest lay. So once I did the foundation, you then apply for the BA, and within the BA I wanted to specialize in fashion, well, textiles for fashion. And at Central St Martin's they do a course where you make the clothes as well as do the textiles, which is pretty much what I do now. So I'm kind of one of the rare people in art and design that studied exactly what they do to this day. So I did BA fashion print for women's wear, and I studied that for 4 years, but one of the years where is where you work in the industry. So I worked at Savile Row for 8 months, and then for the remainder of the year I went and worked in Paris at Dior Couture. So I was in the couture salons where they do all the ready-to-wear, and then they also do the couture show. So I was there for a good stint, and I recommend anyone working in art and design to intern or do a work placement somewhere. That kind of puts you out of your comfort zone, but you kind of learn the ins and outs of how a garment's made, what how it's produced, and start to finish how much work goes into each thing. So I then came back, finished my BA, and then I got a scholarship. So my BA collection was all made out of canvas and hand painted and very rooted in craft, and then that got the attention of Stella McCartney, who's obviously known for sustainable design. So then I won, well, they gave me a grant to do the MA fashion at Central St Martin's, which again is probably arguably the most the kind of destination. That's the only place I would have done an MA, is kind of the most elite place you can do an MA in fashion. So I did MA fashion textiles. And I got the Stella McCartney scholarship for that, so that kind of worked out quite nicely. So I kind of had like everything, the stars have kind of aligned for me, I guess, but obviously lots of hard work. And then in my graduate collection for the MA, I used a vintage Liberty print, and I hand screen printed it and changed it and made it a bit more dynamic and modern. And that got the attention of Liberty in London. They saw the show and they said, okay, this guy's quite cool, can we bring him in? So I did a project for Liberty, and then they actually sponsored my first show. So I did my first London Fashion Week show within the walls of Liberty. So whilst that was going on, I kind of saw a gap in the market for somewhere a destination where you could print textiles within London, because obviously a lot of the textiles that are made within the industry are done in Italy and the lead times are really long. So there was a real niche that was missing in London where big houses, as well as designers and communities, people from the community could come and print, especially on textiles. So I then simultaneously at the same time, I won an award from H&M. And then that award was 50,000 euros. And then with that money, I mean, it's probably the most amount of money I obviously had in my, so I went from being in my overdraft as a student to suddenly having around £42,000 sterling in my account. But I took the risk, well, calculated risk, because I was really passionate about it and I really believed in my idea and a solid plan where a space where people could come and print, I could print for other people as well as produce my own collections. So I invested that money into a print room, which we're currently in. So that's kind of how it all started quite quickly for me, and the ball started rolling quite quickly from there. So in the beginning and to this day, we still do sample runs for Burberry, J.D. Anderson, Loewe. So quite hard hitters in the industry. So even when Burberry changed their logo, we were the first people to sample it and all that kind of stuff within our textile studio. So we kind of have that side of our business where we're sampling, we've got that stream of revenue, and then we also have the side of the business that is women's wear. So with that side of the business, we show at London Fashion Week each season, and maybe if we could roll one of the videos, you'll kind of get a taster of what that entails. So we show every September and February. So yeah, maybe if you can kind of see here, this was kind of a big dollhouse that we made. So we called it the House of Quinn. Big campsite, lots of people, lots of embroidery and prints. We're known for print. Obviously, we have the print studio, so we do printed textiles and embroidery. That kind of gives you a sense of that side of our business, and with that we sell it seasonally, so we do wholesale, so we're stocked on platforms such as Matches, Net-a-Porter, and we're stocked all around the world now, so places like Bergdorf Goodman and all those different kind of places. So that's kind of a solid part of our business also, and then another big part of our business is people who like to collaborate with us. So as part of these collaborations, we've done one for Moncler, and that kind of entailed taking the house codes of that brand, and then someone maybe like younger and fresh can give like a fresh take on the kind of classic Moncler puffer jacket. So this was kind of our couture collection for them. So we had like a ready-to-wear collection that sat alongside this. And then this is kind of a win-win for the brand, because you get so much exposure via Moncler. You get kind of like a stamp of approval, because obviously there's a huge crossover of customers. So the people who had invested in Moncler, who potentially wouldn't have heard of us before, kind of have a direct route into our company as well. So things like that are really good to build the brand and strengthen the brand in terms of image and quality, and obviously revenue for the company. And then we've done, oh yeah, so I missed that big thing. So after I opened the studio, showed at Liberty, I then won an award from the Queen. So that was autumn, winter 18. And that's the season Crystal was working with me. Actually, Crystal worked with me from the very, very beginning. Yeah. So that was an award which was basically about our company as we gave back to the community. So we offer discounted rates to students, we print graduate collections, we're kind of like an open door policy at that point. So it was kind of an award for like the business as a whole. So that was obviously a very interesting experience, being kind of relatively unknown, kind of known-ish in the industry, to suddenly everyone at one point knowing who we were for that day, I guess. But so yeah, so that's been a very, obviously, upwards trek, like a very steep upwards trajectory from there. So we did the Queen show, and then after that, sales and stockists and distribution kind of went crazy. So we kind of had to adapt, and then kind of like adapt our business model to kind of handle the demand, but I feel like we adapted quite well.
Pretty good.
Yeah. And then, so yeah, it's been quite full on. So the most recent thing that we've done is our last London Fashion Week show. But just before that, during the lockdown, we kind of retooled and we stopped for a bit. And because at that point in time, I didn't really feel like there was a need for a fashion show. So we retooled and we used all our kind of surplus fabrics for scrubs for the NHS. So we retooled our factories and started kind of donating masks. We did like a free mask project as well, because again, although it's a company that makes lots of money and things like that, we do have a deep-rooted kind of ethical side to our business as well. We print everything in London. We like to give back to the community. That's why our print studio is kind of an open door policy. So I feel like that's very fundamental to why our business is a successful business as well, because it's kind of outward facing. We're not so closed off, potentially like other brands, in terms of the inner workings. And then towards the end of the pandemic, when everything started to open up, we did kind of like a big film. And this was kind of like a big comeback in terms of just fashion in general. We didn't really go anywhere, but in terms of actual fashion moments, we wanted to do something that was quite impactful. So we worked with a huge cast of basically dancers and actors and all this different kind of stuff. So we kind of did this Hollywood-esque take on... yeah, like a film kind of movie. So this is kind of the opening scene, and then we invited all the editors down to an old cinema in Islington and watched it on the big screen. So, and from this, it's kind of like the best advertising you can give yourself. We've got about three more kind of partnerships off the back of this, and we're currently designing, so we're even printing cabs and different things like that. And also, I forgot to mention, we partner with Epson, so the big print company. So when I first started my studio, they kind of equipped our studio. So I feel like I've done it in quite a clever way, where we've associated ourselves with hard hitters in the print industry. So things like Epson, Liberty of London, Moncler, everything is quite strategic to make sure everything's rooted in quality. And the main part of this film was, there's a huge value in creativity in the industry, and although this was a big spend on the advertising budget, it was really worth it in terms of the value add that we got in terms of digital footprint, but also in terms of collaborations that we've got after this. So we're actually currently designing costumes for a big Hollywood film at the moment. So it's interesting to kind of see, for example, if we did the house show where it was a dollhouse that opened, then Barbie got in contact with us and we did a project with Barbie, and that will kind of grow into a bigger partnership later this year. So it's interesting to kind of see how the different things that you invest in, especially in the creative industry, can really come back, and you're offering something to someone that they don't have or can't do themselves. I feel like that's kind of like the unique kind of part of our business. We have the revenue stream of like the print company, the collaborations, as well as the wholesale. So the next big plan, just to end on this, is we're moving studio to a bigger studio. So I feel like it's going to get hopefully bigger and better, and more people, and more printers, more shows, more videos and things like that. So I feel like the foundation of the company's been what the last 3-4 years has been about. And I feel like it's quite a solid foundation. And then hopefully we'll get bigger and better. But I feel like any advice, and I'm sure you guys can ask questions, but any advice would be, there's lots and lots of money in the industry, especially even if you're a creative and you wanted to go into the film side of the industry. We paid a lot of money for that film. So I feel like there's so many different diverse roles that you can do within the industry. I feel like even if you don't want to be a graphic designer or a printer, even if you're very methodical and you could be a production company or something like that, I really feel like you should really think about the actual people behind the scenes that actually make it happen. And there's obviously like a premium price that they charge and things like that. So there's so many opportunities to make quite big money in the industry. So that's where I'll end it. It's quite exciting to get into. So hopefully that's been helpful for you guys.